What's up, guys? Cass here. Welcome to another GiveWave Studios tutorial. Today we're going to be covering the Traveler's Bow from Breath of the Wild. So what we have here are the top of the bow and the bottom of the bow. So what ends up being the front of your bow, which is basically like this, so you're going to hold it like that, see the curve. So the front of the bow, right here, we're going to cut this at a 45 degree angle. So we're going to make our marks here, and we're going to cut this whole thing at a 45 degree angle. Now you can do this one of two ways. You can do it with an X-Acto knife. Just kind of like hold your knife at one particular angle and just drag it all the way around, making sure that you don't move your hand. I have a bandsaw available at the shop, so I'm going to use that to make it a lot faster. And then,
okay, so let's come back. We have our parts, and as you can tell, right, this is cut at a slight angle all the way through. So I have that same angle just going from, and that angle is on the front of the bow. So now we're going to, I'm going to put this together with contact cement, but I'm going to heat it up first and curve it and give it the general shape of the bow, so I can hold it as we put it together. Now you don't do this angle on the back. You want the back to be a nice round shape. So we're gonna have to really over curve this and really extend it and make it so that it kind of sits flush with the other side on that. And so I'm gonna speed through the process. We're gonna put one of them together real quick. All right, so this is the overall curve that you want to your piece. So you're gonna heat this as many times as possible to really make sure that it keeps this curve. I'm just showing you guys two pieces in comparison, the flat piece versus the nice curved piece that we have. So now I'm gonna do the same thing for the other ones also, and then I'm gonna put our contact cement on the edges, and we're gonna glue everything together, all right?
Okay, so I've heated up my two other parts. See, it has a nice rounded shape to it. So this is the one from earlier, and I've already put it together. So as you can see, I put what I like to call, I stitched the back of it. So you're gonna start with the back, the part that's flat, the part that you didn't cut at a 45 degree angle. That's the part you're gonna glue first, which is the back of the bow. So you're gonna start at the top and work your way down. Now, once this is complete, I like to stitch, meaning basically I take a piece of masking tape, put it up against the foam, pull it, and just kind of like press the two pieces up against themselves. That way, when I glue the front side, I don't have to worry about this coming apart or anything like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and put barge on these other ones and glue them together, and kind of take my time and show you guys a little bit of the process of how to put it together, because it can be a little tricky. All right, so my two pieces are barged and ready to go. I'm gonna get a little closer to the camera because this can be a little tricky. So I like to start, let me get this hot heat gun out of the way. So I like to start at the smaller end, and remember to put your tick marks back onto the foam. If you ordered the kit, this is gonna come with the tick marks. If you got the template for free on Facebook, just make sure you transfer those over. So what I'm doing is I'm really just lining up the edge, right? As I'm gluing this, making sure that the edges touch. I want like as smooth a seam as possible. And I'm just matching up these tick marks. Right? Now when you get to these curved areas, it's gonna be a little bit more difficult. You're gonna have to just kind of maneuver the foam around and make it do what you want it to do. So notice how I'm just kind of like separating it as I'm putting it together, because another thing you need to be careful of is that your back pieces don't touch while you're focusing on the front, because that can be a nightmare. So bending the foam as I put everything together, keep it in mind to keep everything lined up with my registration marks as I go through this process, slowly but surely. Almost there. And Make sure that last little bit lines up properly. All right. We got all of that. We can just kind of maybe press the two sides up against each other and make sure it's glued itself proper. All right, now we have that. So I was saying earlier with the tick marks, I'm just gonna add these real quick because I'm gonna glue the front. So just kind of grab a piece of masking tape and then maybe like every inch and a half or so,
just grab the foam, press it up against itself, and then just slide that over. You should feel some tension there because it should really bring the two pieces together. So you're gonna run that completely down the spine, and then I'm gonna go ahead on the other side and glue the other part. All right, so done with this, the front. Kind of push it up against itself. Now you're gonna notice, you know, like a little bit of an edge, a little bit of a bump. It's fairly simple to get rid of this. Just really sand it down and smooth it out and make it circular like the rest of it. The reason why I do this angle is it brings it into itself. And also once you sand this, you also get rid of the seam, which is nice. All right, so just to show you guys a little bit of a difference. So this is one of the parts that we just made, and this is one that I just sanded down. So you really can completely get rid of these seams just by sanding it away at different grits. So I started with an 80 grit, worked my way to a 120, and then a 200 to just kind of even everything out.
So we got our parts all done up and sanded, and now what we're gonna do is add some detailing to it. Obviously the traveler's bow is just kind of like two pieces of wood. So what you're gonna do is, I'm gonna freestyle this, but what you might wanna do is grab a marker. Okay, so you can grab a Sharpie and literally just kind of grab your laptop, phone, iPad, tablet, whatever, and just look up like the picture of wood grain, right? And just kind of start drawing that into your shapes.
Okay, so as you guys can see, kind of put some wood grain drawings throughout the whole thing. Now you can go as detailed as you'd like with this or as loose as you'd like. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab my X-Acto knife and I'm just gonna slightly score over all of these parts that I drew. Again, you can do this freestyle if you're comfortable with it. I'm just showing you guys that it's just slightly easier to have your lines down first so you know exactly where everything's going, because what can happen if you go straight with the blade, some of the cuts you might not see, so you might be able to go over them. But the next one that I'm doing, I'm just gonna freestyle it and just skip through the whole thing, and then we're gonna heat this and just watch the magic happen with all of the patterns just appearing. Okay. Heating it up, you can see all of our details are nice and open, so we have like this really cool wood grain texture to our part. All right, so for this part, it's a little tricky. So you're gonna grab some scrap foam and you're gonna put your piece down on it. You're gonna trace the outside like that. Okay, so this is the left one, and I'm gonna do the same thing for my right. Okay, now what you're gonna do is you can, one, either just measure the thickness of this and transfer it over, and then, so, you know, it's somewhat something like that. I'm just gonna kind of wing it. I'm trying to give it a little bit more room than it needs because it's easier to take away from the foam than it is to add. So it's looking like I'm giving it about like a quarter of an inch coming in from one side. The reason I don't send the parts pre-made for this is because everyone's bow is gonna come out a little different depending on how much you twisted it when you were heating it up and other factors like that. So this is a step that you're gonna have to
just kind of do and repeat until you get it right. And basically what we're doing is just we're creating like plugs for this. Okay, so I got this nice, and then I'm gonna cut this up. Okay. So once you have your pieces cut out, it should look kind of like this little teardrop thing that I've got going on here, and it should fit nice and snug inside of this piece. So that's what you're gonna do to seal this. I'm gonna make at least 3 of these so I can stack them nice and thick and go through the whole thing. And that's what's going to allow me to put a handle on it, make a stem, kind of like a hole that fits so that it becomes collapsible. So we're gonna do like 3 or 4, depending on how deep you want the stem to go into the up or down side of your bow. And so we're gonna speed through that process and get you guys in a little bit. All right, so grab one of your pieces and you're gonna insert one of those teardrop parts into here. And what you can see here, I just kind of roughly found the center of what that area is going to be. And you're gonna grab your wooden dowel, you're gonna put right down in the center, you're gonna trace around that. And you're gonna do that for all 3 parts. That way the dowel has something to sink into when you do this, all right? So I'm gonna speed up through that process. So I have my circle placed right down my center, and I'm gonna cut this out. Now, one thing to keep in mind is when you cut this out, you wanna cut it much smaller than what your circle actually is, because otherwise this is gonna be too loose when it goes into your pole. So I'm doing like maybe about a 1/4 inch smaller than it needs to be. I'm gonna go around with my X-Acto knife, and your circle doesn't have to be completely perfect. You just want to make sure that you're somewhat on the same path as you go. All right, so that's pretty much it. Now, you see the difference? This is pretty small compared to what my actual circle is. But the foam will expand, and this makes it so that I have a really tight fit on this when I put it inside of the bow. That way it doesn't like flop around on you or anything like that. All right. Bam, 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 bam. All right, so now we have our parts. You should be able to tightly fit this in here, all right? And what you're gonna do is, with like barge or hot glue, you're gonna end up reinforcing this. If you want this to look any cleaner, you can go to the craft store, get like 2 millimeter or one millimeter foam, and just kind of, I'll put some glue on it, stomp it down, and make sure that it just covers the entire surface, re-drill the hole. That way it covers all of the seams here, and you can just kind of like sand and blend it into itself. Right? It's just a little, if you guys wanted to take that extra step. So now this should screw in nice and tight. We're gonna do the same thing here, like so. Okay. All right, that works. We're gonna do same thing with this. Nice and tight. Proper bow right there. Super light. I love that noise. So satisfying. So you're gonna grab your piece of 2 millimeter foam. It's kind of squarish, but it's not really square. And this is what you're going to be. So you're gonna roll it long, along the long side, right? The longest part of it, and that's what's going to give you this little tube that's going to correspond to the it's like the teal wrap part of the bow. And you're just going to bend it into shape and make sure that it fits on top of your bow, and then that'll be that. So I'm going to go through the process of bending this for you guys real quick. All right, so once you have your tubes made, I would bend them, like continue this curve here by bending them towards the seam and the back so that the back seam faces you. I mean, it's gonna get wrapped either way, but it's just a preference of mine. You can do it any which way you want, but I would bend it towards the seam a little bit. That way, when we glue it, it just kind of has a continuation of that curve. So I'm gonna do that there. Or you're gonna grab your glue, your hot glue, your glue cement, whatever glue you're using, grab your glue. And just notice how my part is still just kind of following that general curve. So it's going and then out. So that's the general curve you want for this. I'm just gonna glue my two pieces together, and that will be that. Okay, so with these parts done, you're gonna grab these parts, which are the metal tabs that are gonna go right up on the top there. So I'm gonna put these together with some glue, and then I'm gonna show you guys how to fasten them to the rest of the thing. Okay, so what we're gonna be looking to do is basically a line like this. So I'm gonna put my piece so that it kind of looks like it's hanging right off the edge there. And then once I feel like visually those kind of line up, I'm just gonna hold that and trace my line. And I'm gonna end up cutting this right across at that angle so that when I glue this up to that, it maintains that look and feel. So I'm gonna do it with you guys on this one. So up against that edge there, trying to cut as little as possible of the white stem here. So something like that. I got two similar-ish angles, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut those out. Where is my knife? Just kind of flatten this out and cut that out. So same thing here. Okay, and then now, when I install this, it'll sit nice and flush, and it'll have that nice little Zelda look. Okay. Also, I'm probably gonna end up beveling these edges a little bit with my Dremel tool or the sander, just to give it a little bit of dimensionality. Right now, it's very like flat and just kind of really sharp on the edges. So I'm gonna give it a little bit more, realism, okay? Alright, so just to show you guys the difference between the rough part and the one that I just kind of finessed a little bit and sanded and smoothed out the edges. It's all about preference. You guys might like this look or might not want it as rounded, so it's all up to you. But just showing you guys that it does make a real difference if you at least just kind of play with the edges a little bit and just round them off, alright? Okay, so one hint. When you are going to glue this permanently, leave yourself the slightest sliver between the foam and what's going to be the metal piece. That way you can kind of slide your fabric in there and start your wrap from the top and really make sure that you get the whole thing there. So give yourself a little bit of slack. You can see it just a little bit. So you can slide your fabric in there and wrap it down, and you guys will see why that's useful later on in the video. One of the things that you can do, you can glue the dowel to at least one of the parts, that way it's static, or you can just leave it loose so that you have it on both sides. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys what we've done so far. Alright. Yeah, look at that. Alright, so for these parts, which is kind of like the steel guard at the base of the bow, well, the base of the bow handle, these parts have a slight curve to them, and you're gonna want to cut these at a 45 degree angle, just like we did for the bow earlier. So you're gonna put your X-Acto knife down and just kind of slice at that angle. Okay, so we're gonna have a bit of an angle cut on all of these. Now this is a little harder. You want to follow the curve while doing your 45 degree cut, so do make sure that you have a sharp blade so that this happens as easy as possible for you. All right, I'm gonna run through the steps right now, and then I'll show you guys how to glue it together. All right, so all my parts are cut up at my 45 degree angle. I'm just gonna match up the shapes equally like that. And we're going to put some glue on the edges there and barge them together. Before we do that, you always wanna make sure that you heat your foam and shape it just a little bit before we do that. So we'll get into it. All right. So this little flap right here, it's really important that you heat that nice and good, because you're gonna wanna bend that onto itself outwards like this, so that it stays that way when you actually install it and put it on the piece. It's gonna have like a nice little flare detail and add a little bit of dimension to the overall piece when it's all put together. All right. Pieces ready. I'm gonna go ahead and put these together. So you just want to make sure that your lines are matching up and that you're gluing the edge right to the edge. Okay, like that. And this one's a little tricky because it curves in and out, but just keep following the line. Make sure that your parts are touching. Try not to let the bottom touch. Just focus on one piece at a time. So you get the whole thing to just kind of like sit properly. Just kind of press the edges there, make sure it really glues all the way. All the way to the bottom. Alright. Now, once you have this, you're pretty much set. All you have to do is put it onto your piece and just measure out you know, where it stops, like where you want it to stay and stop. So I'm gonna put these together and just speed through the process. Our guards that we put together earlier, what we're gonna do is wrap them around. So the larger part is going to face the wider part of the wooden part of the bow. And what you're gonna do is, you're gonna bring this forward here, make it touch, and then kind of hold that position, and then bend these back. And where they meet, just kind of follow your center line here in the back, and make a mark. As you can see, I've already made this mark here, and then transfer that mark over on the underneath. And what's gonna end up happening is we're gonna cut these two off, just glue them together, slide everything right in place, and it'll be like a proper snug fit. And if you guys don't want this loose, you can always glue it. All right, now once you've got your fit figured out and you've cut off your pieces, what I've gone on and done here is cut a bunch of craft foam. You can get this like at Michael's or even like at a Walmart or something like that. It's like the 2mm craft foam. And what I'm going to do is I've cut strips long enough to go over these parts. Now, if you don't want to go through this process, that's perfectly fine. You can paint your whole thing silver, and then you can use a paint marker or even like a paint brush to just do some of these highlights in like a lighter silver. But I like giving this a little bit of dimension. It takes a while, but well worth it. So I'm going to speed through that process. Barge on the part so I can glue them together. I'm gonna try it out on the shaft of the bow there and see how it works. Okay, then I'm gonna glue my parts. Remember to just try and keep them as flush as possible so that everything lines up and you have less work to do with sanding and filling and any other stuff. Our complete part. I'm gonna add like some more details. He has like these little, I don't know if you guys can tell, I kind of scored this area a little bit, like some little spikes that come out here and there. So I'm gonna add those in and then paint everything. I'm gonna grab some Plasti Dip, cover this whole thing. I'm gonna do a couple of layers, speed through it. I'm gonna
paint this the satin warm caramel.
Pieces nicely printed. Sorry if my voice sounds muffled, I'm wearing a mask. And now we're just going to do the hammered steel on the tips and also on the brass. And then we'll go right into the assembly.
So now that we got all the parts nice and painted, you can tell that adding those little lines gave like some really nice details to it. So if you have the time to do it, it's definitely worth taking the time to cut out some strips and glue in them in place of everything. Okay, and then so what I'm gonna do now is just weather this a little bit. I'm gonna add some black inside of the open areas and just kind of lightly rub it off so that the paint just kind of stays in the edges, kind of gives it like a dirty look. And then I'm gonna go over the raised detail areas with some rub and buff and just kind of give a little bit of sheen to all the corners. All right, so just to show you guys a bit of a difference, how nice this looks compared to just the flat color of the other one. This has a lot more dimension to it. Looks a little bit more real when everything's said and done. So I'm going to continue with that and we'll go into installation of the rest of the stuff. All right, so we're going to grab our piece, slide that into place. All right, you have it, this thing go all the way down to the bottom of the piece right here. I had mine a little looser, so when I glue it down, I can just kind of push this end out a little bit. It makes the overall size of this look a lot more massive. And then we're just gonna grab a part of our bow, just slide that in there, twist everything into place, make it nice and equal. And there we go. All right, pretty much almost there. Now we're gonna do some, we're gonna wrap some fabric around this for the teal area. We're gonna do the same thing for here. We're gonna wrap with some brown and then some teal at the edges there. So as I mentioned earlier, you can stop here where you just have your inserts, or you can just take it a step further and just kind of blend everything in. So what I'm gonna do for mine is grab a sheet of 2 millimeter foam, and then I'm going to place my piece on it, grab a pen, and trace the general shape out at the bottom. And again, this is one of those extra things that you can do. The shape won't come with your kit because, again, everyone's shape is going to be slightly different. So this is just one of those custom things that you have to do towards the end. They're not going to be perfectly symmetrical, they're going to be different from each other. So I'm going to cut this out, glue it, sand the edges, and we'll just fast forward to that just so you guys get a sense of the process. All right, so once we got our pieces attached, what I'm going to do is just fill around until I find the center hole that the dowel is supposed to go into. Just kind of push it in a little bit. Right, you can see it's dented. Grab an X-Acto knife and just cut a little bit out, just enough so I can start seeing the edge, and then put my knife right up against the edge and open up the rest of it so that it cuts nice and flush to everything, and I have a nice circle towards the end. All right, and then I'm just gonna paint this all up, sand the edges, and match the paint up a little bit. This is probably something I should have done before I started painting, so keep that in mind for you guys. Once you've gotten to the point where everything fits and everything looks good, just do this so that you don't have to paint it twice. Okay, so right here, I've grabbed myself a long piece of string, and I'm gonna tie around the neck of the end of the bow right here. So I'm gonna add some blue. I'm gonna start from the most top part possible off to the side, I'm going to just start wrapping the fabric around that area. Let that dry for a little bit. Alright, I'm going to grab a piece of fabric. I'm going to start this as close to that top as possible. I'm going to start wrapping this downwards. Right. I remember how we left a slit, a slight slit when we put this on. So this was for this reason, so that we can just tuck the fabric up in there. Right. Once I got my top area covered, I'm just gonna, now this is stretchy fabric, so I'm stretching this as I'm bringing it down, but you can use any type of fabric to do this part of your piece. Keep going, kind of bring it into the wood a little bit. And once I get to this last area, I'll grab some glue. Go ahead and glue that down. Grab that. Attach that. So now I'm gonna mark my dowel right here. That way I know how far to put my teal wrap. Because mine just came out a little bit looser than I would have wanted, so that can get taken care of very easily. Alright, Link has his string tied around quite a couple of times. I'm gonna grab me some of this. I'm gonna wrap that around here. Okay, and two. Just gonna string this down. Cut off my excess. And we'll tie that around the base. Add some barge to this general area. And we're gonna enclose that with my piece of fabric. I'm gonna grab my fabric, put some barge on it, and just cover that section itself. Cut it off right there. Like that. I'm gonna do the same thing for the other side.
And once you've done it to the other side, you should have a completed traveler's bow from Breath of the Wild. Congratulations, guys. So I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions or concerns, feel free to leave them in the comment section down below. And I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers.